see him on August the 5th. And wow, how could you have a Night of Legends, anything to do with the history of wrestling in East Tennessee, without including the two men who probably dominated the sport in this part of the country for more years than they care to admit? And I've got a lot of bruises to prove that point, and that is none other than Ron and Don, the Wright brothers. Ron and Don Wright were more than a tag team. They were an institution. The perennial Tennessee Tag Team Champions, they faced and defeated every team to come through the area for years. So well known were they that newspaper headlines simply called them by their first names. But as great a team as they were also top single stars. The brother who took most of the spotlight was the king of Kingsport, the number one hillbilly, Ron Wright. Ron Wright had a reputation with us wrestlers as one of the meanest men in the sport of wrestling. And with the fans, he had a reputation as probably the toughest man who ever lived. And it's universally accepted with the fans and the wrestlers alike that he was the most hated man in professional wrestling. Why? All you have to do is listen to this.
Back at ringside, you know, all kinds of wrestling action will be on the card Friday night at Chill Holloway Park Arena. Tommy Gilbert asked for a match against Dandy Jack Donovan, who turned on Gilbert last night, left the ring after...
Turn that over and be quiet a minute. I've got a little something I want to tell you.
Oh, I don't doubt that.
How come you've got my chair run down slow? You've got it run down low trying to make...
I don't handle chairs, Ron. I don't have a thing in the world to do with it.
Put yours down there a little bit.
That's because you're so
little. I want to tell you something. Let me tell you. I took that loudmouth, dumb old Dromo down there last night. I whooped that man to the point that they had to send 8 wrestlers and John Kazana and all the police in the building in there and hold me and pull me off of him. And that goes to show you what kind of man that he come out here and bragged that he was. What he?
You through?
No, I'm not.
Well,
through.
Have you wondered?
I was just sitting there waiting you to open that big mouth again so I can tell you to shut up. You come down here, all you know to do is sit down here and lie. I don't know why the people down here don't get up a petition and have you fired from down here. They ought to fire you and run you from off a TV hill. Hire me and take your place and give me your job.
Hey,
I do a 10-to-1 better job at it than you do.
It ain't me that got suspended.
Now, let me tell you something. These loud-mouthed idiot referees, they're low-down, conniving. Don't stand there and tell me to wait a minute. I'll smack you from across the ring over there.
Go ahead if you
feel. Just because they put a referee shirt on and hide behind them white and yellow and black stripes, they ought to be yellow stripes because yellow's all you are. Y'all ain't none of you nothing but a bunch of yellow-bellied nitwits.
Before you let your mouth run out, you put your hand...
Who can forget the feud between Ron and the late Whitey Caldwell, especially the brutal Tennessee chain matches? It lasted for years, ending only with Whitey's untimely death in a car wreck in 1972. Ron's wrestling career was filled with titles, blood, record crowds, and glory, and he fought as many fans as he did wrestlers. After Ron's wrestling career was over, he became a manager, with his biggest successes coming with the team of Phil Hickerson and Dennis Condrey, the Stomper and the Dirty White Boy. On August the 5th, Ron and Don Wright, the Wright brothers, will be together in the Knoxville Civic Coliseum for the first time in 20 years. Probably the most popular wrestler ever in East Tennessee, the man we'll be profiling today, Whitey Caldwell. Whitey began wrestling in the mid-1950s at the Kingsport Boys Club, along with two other fellows named Ron and Don Wright, who would go on to achieve some fame themselves. The matches were held to raise money for the boys' club. Admission was free, but concessions were sold. Promoter Mickey Barnes talked Whitey into turning pro, and he began a 16-year career that saw him become a hero to fans in Tennessee, Kentucky, Virginia, and the Carolinas. His most famous rivalry was a series of matches he wrestled against Ron Wright. Look at the main event of any card in the 60s or the early 70s, and Ron and Whitey were there. Whitey held the Tennessee tag title with almost a dozen different partners, including myself. But to the fans, Whitey stood head and shoulders above the rest. Who can forget the time that Whitey won Ron's prized Tennessee walking horse and then sold him at auction? Or the famous Tennessee chain matches? Unfortunately, there aren't many photos of Whitey around these days. He was too modest to allow them to be sold. Finally, when he did, one picture was sold at the matches, but the proceeds went to pay for a young girl's kidney operation. That was Whitey Caldwell for you, always thinking of others. In 1972, while still the Southeastern Wrestling Champion, Whitey was killed in an auto accident after a match in Morristown. His old rival, Ron Wright, took his place the following Friday night at Chilhowie Park. teaming with Dandy Jack Donovan to face Don and Al Green. The match, it sold out. The fans had come to pay one last tribute. In today's world, athletes and celebrities are only as popular as the latest fad. But devoted fans still make the journey to the Kingsport Cemetery, where Whitey Caldwell is buried, and put flowers on his grave 22 years after his death.